The 2021 Stanley Cup Playoffs on Hockey Night in Canada is a presentation of Sportsnet in association with the National Hockey League.
This is the ultimate. You never won a trophy until you won this.
I thought winning once was great, but this one is the best.
I was crying in the bench because I was so happy.
It's a dream come true.
He's diagnosed with Alzheimer's. He doesn't remember a lot of stuff, but you bet your ass he's going to remember this one.
It's the time of the unexpected, the time of the upsets.
There's so many generations and eras of different players and people who have left their mark on the game.
And a good move, and a good move! Shoots, he scores! What a goal!
The Stanley Cup is about sacrifice.
Oh, time is nailing McSorley!
You do anything to move on.
I can't wait!
It comes down to one thing, it is a team spirit, team effort.
Another shot, score! Eiserman! Around the net, waiting, he's open! Gilmore!
Michael Foot!
Look at the bill! Oh my goodness! What a goal! Oh baby!
Here's Fleury! Scores!
Hurry on! Score!
Countdown is on.
Nobody can take it away.
I'm speechless. It's one of the greatest feelings in the world.
This is when the pressure gets higher. And the spotlight brighter.
Wayne, there's been a lot of trophy presentations to you, as I recall, every time. It was nothing means anything until we get the Stanley Cup.
But that's hockey. It's a fiercely competitive sport, played to the limit by high-salaried stars, whose supreme physical condition enabled them to provide the full 60 minutes of sustained speed and action.
This is when tempers flare and tensions boil over. It's time to go all in.
Under a shroud of a pandemic, silent arenas, 16 teams thinned from 31.
Reserve a table for 25 in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Let's go! Speedy all the way to the net and he scores! What a play! What a save! My goodness, what a stop by Spencer Knight!
Poise and calm from this kid.
Kaprizov with his 26th!
This glorious punishing test begins now, where other famous hands had been so many times before.
Gretzky scores! The greatest goal scorer in National Hockey League history! Raymond Moore, a dream has come true! The waiting is over! The New York Rangers won the Stanley Cup champion!
Now comes someone else's turn.
Lately, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. But baby, I've been I've been praying hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars. Like a swinging vine, swing my heart across the line. In my face is flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. Kills me, makes me feel alive. Hey, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, except no more counting dollars. River every turn, hope is our four-letter word. Make that money, watch it burn. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. Drowns me, makes me wanna fly. Yeah, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars.
To the Stanley Cup Playoffs, presented by Geico.
Game 4, Bruins and Capitals. everybody. Thanks so much for joining us. Kenny Albert along with Eddie Olczyk, Brian Boucher inside the glass. The first three games of this series have all gone to overtime. Eddie, neither team has led in any game by more than one goal.
Yeah, it's been tight. We've seen the Stars do what they're supposed to do for the most part. But I think, Kenny, what I've seen, especially the last couple of games, is that when the team has had the momentum, they've been able to cash in. You think about the third period the other night. The Capitals had six straight scoring chances, not able to give a little bit of separation. And then in overtime, the Boston Bruins outchanced the Capitals 7-2. So momentum swings all over the place.
Bruins have trailed in the third period in each of the last two games. They tied both games, and then Marchand and Smith with the OT winners.
Well, come playoff hockey, the rink shrinks, right? It gets a lot smaller, and you got to be able to have the willingness and want to get to tough areas. Go back to game two. The Bruins down. Look at all the people in front of the net. Eventually, Taylor Hall scores right from the blue paint. Trailing the other night in game three. Look at Brad Marchand. Great hand-eye coordination. Puts it to the back of the net. Eventually, the OT winner. Craig Smith takes it right to the blue paint. So the common theme for the Boston Bruins, the way that Bruce Cassidy, the terrific head coach of the Boston Bruins, wants to play, Kenny. Let's go straight ahead. Let's go to the blue paint. And there's a perfect example.
Bruins lead the series 2-1. What must the Washington Capitals do tonight to even this series before heading back home?
Well, good news for them. It looks like Lars Eller is going to be back. So the center ice position is going to get a little deeper for Peter Laviolette. But pretty simple, Kenny, for me. Backstrom, no points. Carlson, one assist. Ovechkin, one goal. That's on the power play. Tom Wilson, one goal. Oshie's got one. So I think they need their big guys to be a little bit better 5-on-5, and I think the power play needs a little bit of an adjustment, especially on their entries. And look, Ilya Samsonov played a terrific game the other night in that game three. He hadn't played in about 3 or 4 weeks. We're going to bring in Brian Boucher inside the glass. And Bouch, that was the only blemish he had on his resume the other night, in my opinion, and the only reason that game got to overtime, because the way he played. But again, the gaffe in overtime cost this team a big win.
It did, and he's going to have to shake it off, Edzo. You're right. He was fantastic in the game. I mean, you think about the chances that the Boston Bruins had. You alluded to it in the overtime. 7-2 in overtime. Shot for 19-8. He's not the only one to blame on this situation. Brendan Dillon went for a change, a miscommunication with Justin Schultz. He didn't play the puck, but he has to forget about it. The reality is, he gave his team a chance to win. He's gonna have to be as good, if not better, here tonight in game four if they want to send this back to Washington tied at 2.
Game four coming up from Boston. Bruins, Capitals, next. Welcome back to TD Garden. For the franchise record, 53 career postseason victories. The last 12 playoff games between these clubs have been decided by one goal, extending an NHL record. Overtime at all three in this series. Hall, Krejci, and Smith start for Boston up against Mantha, Backstrom, and Oshie. Lars Eller returns.
Big bad Bruins are getting ready to fight for the puck in their historic hometown of Boston, Massachusetts. Greetings, everyone, with Eddie Olczyk, Ray Ferraro coming up in just a moment. I'm Mike Emrick. We have reached a game four. You're away from home. You're down in the series 2-1. What do you tell your team?
We win this one. We can make it a best of three. We have home ice. Let's worry about what we do. Don't worry about what might happen if you don't find a way of winning the hockey game. Give yourself a chance. Let's tie it up, and let's get back home and make it a best of three.
Washington's got to find a way to extend this series because, as we've seen in the past, going down 3-1 is not the recipe for success. Win this game, you got a serious chance to win this series.
Let's look at the starting netminders. From a win last game, we'll try to keep playoff momentum with this game. A forgettable start last time. He got blown out. A must-win for him to prove that he can stay in that goal crease in the future. Taylor Hall, after 6 years in Edmonton, arrived in New Jersey and in his second season rolled off a franchise record string of 19 consecutive games with at least a point.
Blocked. An enormous hit.
Look
looks like he arrived at the rink in a bad mood. Maybe he missed his wake-up call. That early hit is an angry one.
It's dropped. They lock up, and that's a good job by the winger.
He gains the zone. Pass comes to him from the crease. Shoot! Score! He got the post with that one.
Jumped up on the bench beside me pretty quickly here. Very excited on the one side to have the game's first goal.
Bergeron's goal has gotten his team ahead.
Boy, you could just feel the energy in this building right now after that early goal.
The Bruins win the draw. What's next? Let's the shot fly. Great save. John holds on and gets that whistle.
Time of the goal, 1 minute, 55 seconds.
Washington's got a face-off win. Good keep at the line. More attack coming. Pitching it to Carlson. Directing that one to Ovechkin. Zone to zone to Oshie. He shut him right down. Looking to more. Boston skating in their own end, trying to get to the neutral zone. Gains the zone. Shoots. Save. On to Carlson. And he steps across the line. Slid back across from one point to the other. Pass attempt to Pastrnak. One on one. Smart recovery by Carlson. Tries to get it on net. Turned aside with a pad. Carries it on in from center. A shot. That one's deflected. Skill play by Marchand. He's got no hip pocket. It's a good thing. He just got swiped. Outstanding body contact.
Oh, that is a great hit. I love that hit. In the open ice, you really send a message with one of those.
Save. Shoots one. And yet another save. How does he do that?
I thought the second save was better.
And that's directed up the wing to DeBrusque. Takes it in from the neutral zone. Got a piece of that one. Big drive. That's a great save. Decides he wants the corner. Slid to Corrali. Let's it go. Deflected off the blocker. Walks the blue line. Takes a shot. Broken right up. Centers it. Point-to-point pass. Possession in the zone. Puck at the point. Sends it across the blue line. Heaves one. Saved with a blocker. Collected in the corner. Gets it back. Good solid poke check there. He's got that pass off the wing and can move ahead. Took that away in his own zone. He's in on an onside play. Let's it go. Saved there. Oh, snaps the shot. Save. And freezes play for the whistle.
I sure don't like that that's the best option that they had out of that man advantage break. The goaltender made a pretty easy stop.
Just under 3 minutes remaining in the first. Boston's ahead, 1-0. from the faceoff, and they lock up in a good reach. That's help from the wing. Nicely received at the point. Brings the shot. Didn't have time, but he saved it anyway.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
And a save. The clock has bled down to the last minute. Score!
Worked on this shot before because that's such a quick release and he snaps it home.
He doesn't even move. Once he drops into the butterfly, you're certain he's got the net covered. He just doesn't.
Neutralized faceoff win. Back on his stick. Puck is thrown to Moore. Now it's directed to Krejci. Crosses that line. All part of generating an offense, little pass off from the goal. Minutes have come and gone. A rest for the players as we prepare for period number two. A pair of pucks entered the net in that period, both from the same set of sticks. It's 2-0. We turn to the shots on goal, heavy for one, light for the other. A lucky 13 for the Bruins and 3 for the Capitals. The Bruins end the period with a two-goal advantage. We focus on this one, the one that made it two goals, and we'll have more in just a moment. We have 20 minutes down. We have lots of time still to go. What are your thoughts so far, Edson?
The Capitals didn't play with the puck much in that first period. It's reflected on the scoreboard. They'll need to gain more possession time in order to generate more chances and turn things around.
Nicely into the zone. Laid on to Moore. Snaps a wrister. A terrific block he got right in the way. Played towards the corner by Oshie. Takes it up near the boards. From the slot, a wrister. Made the save. Strong wrister. He was standing in the lane and got some of it. Dogged determination there by Chara. Pitching this one to Ovechkin. Not a free puck now. Passing one off now to Bergeron. A great speed bump set up there. Chip to Carlo. Trying to go to Hall. That puck is loose. No luck getting through that time. Heaves one. Not on the net.
This was a heavy shot, but it had no chance of going in because it missed the net.
This is a tough one to work with. A kick pass out of that. Moving it to Chara. Snapping a pass to Mantha. Pitching it to Carlson. Round through the corner. He throws it there. Terrific save.
The Bruins have dominated much of this game defensively. They've denied shots to the net. Their goaltender hasn't had much to do, but he's been sharp on the relatively few chances he's had.
He scores! 3 straight goals.
Chance, quick hands allowed him to snap that one off and score the goal.
The goalie's at the mercy of the shooter here, Edzo. He tried to make a dramatic glove stop, just no dice.
Boston's built a 3-0 lead in this game, and they've had the puck almost the entire time. Washington's won that neutral zone faceoff.
63, Brad Marchand.
That one dropped back into the opposite corner. Directing that one to Kasha.
David Pastrnak.
Gets in, looks over his options here. Blockered away. Swept on to Hagelin. Shoots it on. Wonderful stop. Gets a little drop off from the goalie here. Looking to Smith. Puts one on. Waffle boarded. Great job on a cut pass. Has it back deep. Boston's in possession as they travel through the neutral zone. Shoots one. Oh, lightning score! 4 goals in a row for the same team.
It doesn't waste any time snapping that home.
I'm not so sure the goalie had his angle shut down properly. That's too much room up on the top of the net on the stick side. He's beaten clean.
Boston's hammered home yet another goal. They've got a lot of shots, and now they've got goals to show for their effort. And the faceoff's won.
Scored by number 60.
Driving in from no man's land.
Assisted by number 12.
Terrific determination by Van Riemsdyk.
11 minutes, 39.
It's dumped in. Lost the puck, just couldn't get by. Cut that pass in his own end. Pass attempt to Coyle. Skill play by Smith. Ran into the defense, he's lost it. Collected by Dillon. Washington's along the wing at center ice. Shoots. Terrific point-blank save.
Now that's a beautiful stop on a great scoring chance.
Breaks free. Propelled to Corrali. Good save there. Quick wrister. And ring more bells on that one. One after another.
Rath's able to make what turns out to be a relatively routine butterfly stop.
Over 3 minutes remaining in the period. The lead becomes bigger. It's now 4 goals. Boston's got another win. Shoots. Really quick grab. Washington's in their own end, hoping to make a play to center. Played in the corner by Sherry. And at an angle to Chara. Blocked. And still another save. What a show. It's all on his shoulders. And off target with that one.
He found himself in all alone and just missed a golden opportunity.
Score!
Drifted that shot. That left the goaltender behind in the dust.
Carlo's able to clear open ice, and he lays a sweet saucer pass on the shooter's stick.
The Bruins have built a tremendous lead and also built some wonderful confidence. What will they say in the second intermission? Probably not much. On to Ovechkin. Puck is thrown to Carlson.
Time of the goal, 19 minutes,
25
seconds.
Two periods are in the books here, and so one more to go, and maybe overtime, but it's been an entertaining first two. Let's check out the shots on goal through these two periods. 24 for the Bruins and 8 for the Capitals.
Be sure to get next year's season tickets now at this year's locations and prices.
Washington's goaltender has had one of those nights, and so this score is lopsided, and we will return after he gets a rest and these words. We are entering the third period. Based on the first two, what are you expecting to happen?
Boston's been terrific through two periods of play. They can't sit back now, though. I'm expecting a third period push from the opposition.
We are underway in period three of a game with lots of scoring, but one team's gotten most of it. Good shooting place. Great save. And a save. Washington's on the move up the wing. A shot. Just missed the net with that one.
When the puck sounds hard when it hits the end boards, that means you've missed the net. Scoring chances handed away.
Save. Washington's back in its own end, trying to work forward. Perfect tip by the stick. That puck was obstructed by a screen. Slid to Kuznetsov. Good, solid defensive play with the stick. Steps across that line. Dangles in tight. And now it's directed to Oshie. Intercepted pass. Beside the line. Things are heating up with that hit.
Bergeron's often the object of a target. He's so good, nobody wants to give him much room. But he gets tagged then.
Save there. That puck is held, and the whistle stops play.
Oshie's not out of position at all here. He's in the right spot. That allows him to deliver this check.
Good job on the draw. Goalie's one of the six guys on the ice. He can pass. He did that. Pitching this one to Mantha. Let's it go. Well done with that pass. Got it at the point. That pass along the boards. Shot. Pass save. That defuses the attack for now.
Incredible nonstop action, Doc. Now we got a faceoff.
Oh, the goaltender read this really well. He's down in the butterfly, and he's going to stop this all day.
A little over 7 minutes have been skated so far. Who would have thought five goals, but all of them from one team? Boston's got a defensive zone win. Into the attacking end. The lane was jammed, and it hit somebody. Feeds the point. Looking from the blue line. And down to Mantha. Points it. A shot. Save. Left wing pass to DeBrusque. Leads that charge into the zone. Got his pad on that one. Hangs on to that one, and he'll see a faceoff right near him.
Goalies have to make a half a dozen great stops in a win. This is one on a beautiful move, but there is nowhere for the puck to go.
The Bruins win the draw. Scorches one. Got a piece of that one. Passing one off now to Hagelin. And he dumps it in. The Bruins lug the puck in the defensive zone. Moves it to the barrier at center ice. A great wrist shot. You can almost count that one, but no.
The Bruins goaltender has been terrific tonight. Locked in from the very beginning. Now they try to protect the shutout down the stretch.
and he steps across the line. Shoots one, deflected off the blocker. Trying to go to Corrali, moving it to Lazar. Piked in the slot, got in front of another one.
He had his eye on the puck the whole time. What a stop.
Has it in his own end. Snapping a pass to Corrali. Nicely into the zone. Twist one. Lightning-like reflexes there. Great glove save.
Anderson's going to be able to make that save all day. His positioning is perfect. It's not a difficult scoring chance.
The Bruins win it. Shoots. Shooter tempted to stare at the ceiling on that one. What a glove grab. Got that win. Shoots one. Score! That's his first playoff goal.
Moore's wrist shot was heavy and quick.
I'd like to see every shot go off the goal post and into the net. There are too many that hit the post and go out. This one hits and goes in.
Boston's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. Puck drop, face off one, and the winger stepped right in.
Assisted by number 73, Charlie McAvoy.
He's got that point pass. That puck's loose, mishandled. Marvelous save. A great chance was no chance. And so the final minute of period number three. One team has really looked forward to the end of this one. The other is going to enjoy even these last seconds. The puck heads to neutral zone, and look, it's just like a magnet. Everybody goes there. Can start the attack going in the zone. Paddled aside. And that's an offside.
I don't think the shooter got much on this, but the goaltender makes an excellent stick stop on a relatively easy shot.
The Bruins got that faceoff win, now what? Played on to Carlo. Swept aside. Brister had it away. Wonderful work done near the blue line. Kane's that offensive line. A shot, outstanding point blank save.
Great opportunity, better stop.
The Bruins skated up on the side. Snaps one in there. The offense was strong, but the pad had the answer. So now, just one win from ending the series. A 3-1 lead in a best of seven.
The lead gets extended here tonight, and we're one win away. They've got some cushion, but now's not the time to take the foot off the gas.
And as the tournament moves closer to its conclusion, we hope you'll anticipate the next games as much as we do. This one was fine for us tonight. We hope you enjoyed it, and good night for all of us.